Hello and welcome to this course on MATLAB programming for numerical computations. We are in module 5 covering methods to solve nonlinear algebraic equations. In this lecture, that's lecture 5.5, I'm primarily going to cover how we can use a MATLAB function fsolve. Previously, we have used another MATLAB function f0. F0 was able to solve an equation in a single variable. Fsolve, on the other hand, is capable of solving multiple nonlinear algebraic equations simultaneously. Before we move on to the contents of today's lecture, let us just recap what we have done so far in module 5. What we have done is we have taken an example of fx equal to 2 minus x plus ln x equal to 0 and solved this single variable equation to obtain the value of x that gives the solution. In the first lecture, we covered a method known as bisection method. We wrote our own code in order to solve this equation and find the solution. In the second lecture, we showed how we can use the MATLAB function f0. In the next two lectures, we covered fixed point iteration and Newton-Raphson's method. Both of these can be extended to multiple variables. However, in lecture 3 and lecture 4, we covered fixed point iteration and Newton-Raphson method for the same example 2 minus x plus ln x. We use this example to also demonstrate some of the properties of the numerical methods that we have covered in the four lectures. What comes next is the following. In this lecture, we are going to look at how we can use MATLAB function fsolve. First, we are going to use fsolve to solve the same equation 2 minus x plus ln x equal to 0. In the next lecture, we are going to look at multivariate Newton-Raphson's method to solve n equations in n unknowns. So let's get started with the contents of today's lecture, where we are going to use the MATLAB function fsolve to solve the single equation in single variable 2 minus x plus ln x, and then we are going to extend it to multiple variable example. Okay, so how to use the function fsolve? The syntax of function fsolve is very similar to the function f0. So in this case, our variable x is going to be a vector. Okay, as we have discussed earlier, x is going to be a column vector. So it has n rows and a single column. So it's an n by 1 vector. The solution is going to be xsol, okay, and that is also going to be n by 1 vector. And the function fun name is a function file that will calculate a vector valued function f as a function of the vector x. Again, because we are interested in solving n equations in n unknowns, f is going to return, or the function fun name is going to return n values it will be returned as a column vector. Okay, and we need to provide initial guess, and the initial guess has to be of the same dimension as number of variables. Unlike f0, we do not have to provide initial guesses that bracket the solution. We only have to provide the initial guess that we feel is the best guess for the solution that we are expecting. Okay, so let's look at an example. We'll use fsolve in order to solve the nonlinear equation 2 minus x plus ln x equal to 0. Let me go to MATLAB and so let's look at the function that we have already created. We had already created the function called fun for bisect, okay, where the function value, it calculated the function value 2 minus x plus ln x, okay, and that is what we want to solve. So as I had said here, our fun name is a function that calculates f of x. Okay, fsolve is the MATLAB function that will solve f of x equal to 0. It needs somehow a function that calculates for it the value f of x. Okay, and that is what we are going to provide over here. And we are not going to modify that function at all. Okay, and we are just going to use the syntax as shown over here. Fxsolve equal to, or the solution or the result equal to fsolve, okay, at x, that's the variable that we want to solve for, name of function for bisect x is fsolve at x space fun for bisect in brackets x. That's how we call this particular function and pass it on to fsolve, and we need an initial guess. So let's say the initial guess, in this case let's take the initial guess as 1, okay, and let's just press enter. When we give an initial guess as x equal to 1, okay, we land into a problem. The reason why we get this problem is, let's look at this particular function. Now this function has a maxima at x equal to 1. So for example, if you differentiate this, as we had seen in the earlier lecture, we get this as minus 1 plus 1 by x. Okay, minus 1 plus 1 by x at x equal to 1 is going to be equal to 0, which means that particular guy is either going to be a maxima or a minima. Okay, so if we take d square, we are going to get minus 1 by x square, which is a negative value at x equal to 1, which means that it is a maxima. So this function, as we had seen earlier, goes through a maxima at value of 1. Okay, so unlike f0, where we needed to give a solution that give initial guess that brackets the solution, here we need to provide a reasonable value of the initial guess. The problem with providing the value of initial guess equal to 1 is that the method such as Newton-Raphson or fsolve cannot proceed, because the slope calculated at x equal to 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so that is one of the problems that both fsolve as well as Newton-Raphson method faces. You cannot start with an initial guess that is a local minima or a local maxima. What we are going to see next is, if we start with an initial guess which is to the left of that maxima, we are going to reach the first solution. If we start with an initial guess to the right of the maxima, we are going to reach the second solution. Okay, so let's take an initial guess to the left, and that initial guess, for example, is 0.5. Okay, and let's solve this. When we solve this, we get the result. MATLAB tells that the equation is solved, and the solution xsol is equal to 0.1586. Recall that was the solution, the left solution that we obtained in the previous lecture. Okay, now let's take an initial guess of x equal to 2, and let's see what happens when we take an initial guess of x equal to 2. The xsol ends up becoming 3.1462. So we get now to the second solution. Finally, a third set of initial guesses are going to be to the right of the second solution. So let's take that value as 5 and see whether the fsolve converges or not. When we take the method 5 again, we take the initial guess as 5, again we get the result that the equation is solved and the solution reached is the second solution, 3.1462. Okay, so with that we come to the end of the first example, which was a single variable example. Okay, the single variable example that we used in fsolve, we saw that we were able to use the exact same subroutine, the exact same function as we used in f0 in order to return f of x. Once that particular function was passed on to fsolve, fsolve was able to solve the nonlinear algebraic equation for most of the initial guesses, but it was not always able to solve that equation. Okay, one of the cases when it is unable to solve this equation is if we start at, or if we start close to, a local minima or a local maxima, as we saw when we started with x not equal to 1. Okay, next we are going to cover multivariable examples. Okay, and the example that I'm going to cover is a three-dimensional system. So we have our solution variable x. In the f of x, Our x is going to be a three-dimensional variable and f is going to be a three-dimensional vector-valued function. For this, we are going to take an example of what is known as the Lorentz system. The Lorentz system was a first example that demonstrated chaos, and it's an extremely interesting example for people to learn. And if you want to look at or try to get some idea about what Lorentz equation is, you can go to this Wikipedia article over here. We are going to get these equations, x minus y equal to 0, 2x minus xz minus y equal to 0, and xy minus 3z equal to 0. Okay, so let's go and try to solve this using MATLAB. Lorentz system. Okay, we'll create a new file. Function fval equal to Lorentz system x. Okay, so we have used capital X as the input variable over here. Let's define our define three variables, x equal to x1, y equal to x2, z equal to x3. Define f of x. Okay, so f val 1 comma 1 equal to f val 2 comma 1 equal to f val 3 comma 1 equal to. Again, we had said multiple times earlier that we are interested in ensuring that fval is going to be a column vector. That means n number of rows and a single column. Okay, so we have x minus y as the first equation, 2x minus xz minus y, 2 multiplied by x minus x multiplied by z minus y. That's the second f, and the third is xy minus 3z, x multiplied by y minus 3 multiplied by z. Okay, let's save this. Okay, and let's go to our command prompt. Okay, so now we need an initial guess. So let's take the initial guess as 1, 1, 1. 1, 1, 1. Okay. And we will use x solve equal to f solve at, let's say, x Lorentz system x comma x naught. That's the initial guess, and that should give us the solution x solve. I'll press enter. Equation is solved, okay, and the solution is 1.7321, 1.7321, and 1. If you take these equations and try to solve these, you will find that Lorentz equation, a Lorentz system, has three solutions. One solution is root 3, root 3, 1. Another solution is minus root 3 minus root 3 1, and the third solution is 0 0 0 or the origin. Okay, so let's try to get the other solution also, x 0. Instead of saying is 1 1 1, let's say x 0 was minus 1 minus 1 1, and let's now try to find x solve. And when we do that, we get the other solution, minus root 3 minus root 3, 1.0. Okay, so let's try another initial guess. And in this case, let's say the initial guess was, say, minus 1 minus 1, 0. Let's try with that. Okay, and x solve, when we try, okay, we get the solution which is approximately equal to 0. Keep in mind that we are not getting the solution exactly 0. Why? Because we have a stopping criteria. And the stopping criteria in fsolve is that the tolerance value for x is 10 to the power minus 6. Okay? And that you can, let's say, help fsolve. Okay? there is a command called optim options, and optim options is the command that you can use in order to change the optimization properties, in which case you will need to give the command for solving fsolve as shown over here, where option comes from, the vector options come from this optim options. Okay, so let's look at optim options. Let's say fsolve. Okay, when we type this, okay, we get what are the default option that fsolve uses. The default option is that the function tolerance that we specify in order to say fx equal to 0 is 10 to the power minus 6. The tolerance on x, that is our solution variable, is also 10 to the power minus 6. So as long as our solution differs from the true solution by less than 10 to the power minus 6, our method is going to converge, going to be said to have converged. In this case, the true solution was 10 to the power, sorry, the true solution was 0, okay? And when the solution was comes out to be 10 to the power minus 7 multiplied by 0.3.3.5, that means we are closer to 0 than the function tolerance, sorry, than the variable tolerance tall x value, okay? So with that, we come to the end of this lecture. What we covered in this lecture were two things: single variable fsolve and a multivariable fsolve. We took the example of Lorentz equation for the multivariable fsolve. Okay, with that, I come to the end of this lecture, and I will see you in the next lecture. Thank you.